In the U.S., different communities don't have the same healthcare opportunities. This results in differences in health outcomes. For example, Black children generally experience higher rates of asthma than white children. How can we address these differences? Some people may think providing equality in healthcare would help, but because different groups of people have different barriers to accessing healthcare, not all people have the same needs. This is why health equity is a better option. But how is health equity different from equality? Let's use the example of a bicycle to explore this question. The people in this group are different from one another in age, ability, and sex. In a system based on equality, each person would be given the same bicycle to ride. But what happens when this diverse group of people try to ride the same type of bicycle? Only one of them would be able to ride it effectively. Often, plans to address health inequities are like this scenario. They try to provide everyone with the same type of care, but by doing so, they leave many people without the care they need. What can be done to fix this? Instead of equal care, governments and healthcare providers can strive to give everyone equitable care. This means that people receive healthcare that specifically suits their needs. What does this look like in practice? Let's take another look at the example of asthma. A Black child from a lower-income urban area and a white child from a higher-income suburban area are both diagnosed with asthma. If they receive equal care, they would both receive inhalers. These can treat the symptoms of asthma, but they can't treat the underlying factors that contribute to asthma, such as higher exposure to pollution or social inequalities. What would equitable care look like instead? Since the Black child lives in an environment with higher levels of air pollution, they need additional treatment, like an air purifier or a nebulizer. The doctor who treats them also needs to consider that there might not be any well-resourced health facilities in their area. This means the child's caregivers would have to travel further to pick up their treatment and may not be able to do so regularly. In this case, the doctor could help organize a service to deliver the prescribed treatment. These are examples of equitable care. It doesn't only treat the patient's condition, but also their specific needs. Although health equity prioritizes the needs of the individual, we must remember that it needs to happen on a larger scale. This requires collective action. Collective action can take many forms, including protest action, hiring more diverse staff, and translating research findings into policy. Health equity is about providing fair opportunities for all people to be as healthy as possible. To achieve this, governments and policymakers should work to provide everybody with access to care that fits individual needs, and communities should foster an environment that supports this access. Because equitable healthcare benefits everybody, it leads to improved health outcomes for all.